Hello and welcome to another episode of How to Atom Audio. My name is Stephan Mauer. I am the product manager at Atom Audio. And today I would like to share some thoughts on the so-called burn-in process, what it's all about, the impact on studio monitors and ways how to deal with it. So what do people mean by burning in a studio monitor, a subwoofer or a headphone? In a nutshell, this refers to changing the acoustic behavior of a brand new set of speakers or transducers at the very beginning of them being used. After using speakers for a while, they will settle into a permanent state that they are meant to be in. By then, they are burned in. In case you are unfamiliar with the physics behind speaker technology, this may sound odd or even worrying, but there are good reasons for this, and it all starts with the way electrodynamic drivers like woofers are working. A driver can be described as a so-called mass spring system. In a driver, we have some elements forming a mass, being mainly the membrane and the voice coil, that needs to move back and forth in order to create sound, representing the audio signal we feed the driver with. The suspension system comprising the surround and spider is acting as a spring, holding the membrane in a null position when there's no audio coming in, and it also impacts the movement or excursion of the mass when the membrane wants to follow said audio signal. When designing a driver, you have to consider a lot of aspects, like its intended frequency range, dispersion, SPL, power handling, distortion, and of course, which materials to use to achieve the ultimate goal, a neutral, truthful speaker that does not color the original audio signal. Due to the characteristics of the materials, the brand new suspension often is stiffer than it's actually designed and intended to be, and therefore inhibiting the movement of the membrane to some extent, which causes unwanted distortion. During the burn-in process, the inner structure of the driver's suspension is stressed and changes towards the desired behavior. Only after the burn-in process, the components do operate as intended. You could compare this process to wearing in a brand new set of leather shoes. Right out of the factory, it will be very stiff and probably somewhat uncomfortable to wear, and you would not want it for a long hiking tour. In this example, this is the equivalent to working on an important project with brand new speakers. After a while, the leather becomes softer and you could wear those shoes forever without really noticing them. And that's a state you would like to achieve with your studio monitors as well. Once burned in, modern materials do not alter their characteristics anymore and thereby ensure a true representation of the audio signal. As a result, you can work with and rely on your studio monitors for many, many years without worrying about a potential aging process. If you think about it, a speaker that would change its behavior every now and then due to wear out of the used materials is amongst the worst things that could happen to a sound engineer because the point of reference would constantly float. Making sure that this does not happen and choosing just the right materials plays a big role in the research and development process of a new driver. So, what do you do after purchasing a new pair of studio monitors? We recommend to feed your new monitors with noise or any audio material that is using the better part of the spectrum at a reasonably high volume for the duration of 8 hours before using them in a serious project. After this period, you are definitely on the safe side and should not encounter any further changes in the sound representation. Here's one tip for the burn-in. During the procedure, you can reduce the noise spill significantly by positioning the speakers face-to-face and inverting the phase of the signal for one of them. As a result, the low frequencies will cancel out, so you and potentially your neighbors will not be exposed to 8 hours of noise. Please bear in mind that with new speakers, you as a listener also go through a learning process. That means that you may perceive the sound of your studio monitors differently after a few weeks of using them than you did at the start. There are different opinions about the burn-in process out there that can turn into heated discussions. I personally try to stay out of that. A serious manufacturer has tested the used materials extensively and knows about their behavior over time. So the given recommendations for the burn-in period are pretty reliable and can usually be found in the user manual. Sometimes the manufacturers even take care of the burning in for you, like we do with our S-Series. So with S-Series speakers, you can start doing critical work straight out of the box. That's it for now. We hope that you find this information useful. Please let us know your feedback and which topics we should cover in the future in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Tschüss!